Yes, good morning students. Today we are going to discuss about stack in data structure. Okay, before that, the last class, so far we discussed about the basic introduction about linked list and what are the, hello?
All of you mute your video. Who has opened the video?
Anushan, madam, you need to mute your video. Circular linked list. Okay. Then one more topic we discussed, what are all the applications of linked list. Okay. In that application part, we discussed one major applications we discussed. What the application we discussed in the last class? Any one of you? What are the applications we discussed in the last class? Any one of you? Yes, the very important applications of the linked list we discussed in the last class. Any one of you? Give your answer in chat box. Yeah, see, the lot of applications, the music player and CPU memory allocation we discussed. But which one we have taken that example and we can manipulate everything. We performed lot of operations on that. Which example we discussed? Yeah, polynomial manipulations. Okay, Ritika, implementation of hash table. I have given one of the example, but we discussed more on polynomial manipulations. Okay, in that linked list applications, polynomial manipulation, we discussed the polynomial addition, polynomial subtraction, and polynomial multiplications. Okay, so after this, these are all the basic concepts about linked list. Okay, the one of the linear data structure, example of linear data structure. Now the forthcoming five slides, we are going to discuss about linear data structure, stack and queue. Okay, there are two data structures we are going to discuss about, stack and queue. Now today's session, we are going to discuss about the stack data structure. Okay, this is one of the linear data structure. Here in this today's class, yeah, we don't have the MCQ of recap previous session polynomial manipulation, because end of this session you have quizzes there. Okay, which is the details about the entire first unit one topics, that is all the operations of linked list, applications, example, all the basics concepts. Okay, in that quiz you have 15 questions, 15 MCQ questions, each carries 1 mark, then 5 2-mark questions. Okay, the 5 2-marks carries if you give the answer, read the question properly, and you have to select the answers in checkbox. Okay, wow. From that question, you find out the what is the most keyword we are using, that you have to select from the checkbox. Okay, so totally the mark of that quiz is 25 marks. Okay, 15 MCQ 1 mark, then 5 2 mark questions. Last end of the session, I will put the link in chat box. Okay, now then today's topic. What is a stack data structure? Okay, it's a very easy concept. Already we discussed lot of example in the very first class in stack. Okay, here the main definition. What's the definition of stack? Is nothing but is a linear data structure. Okay, in that linear data structure, we are going to follow some strategy that is called as last in first out, or we can call it as first in last out order. Okay, then one more constraint on that in stack, the insertion and deletion can be done at only one end of the stack. Okay, that is always called as top of the stack. These are all the two constraints. Okay, stack is nothing but we all know that this is a linear data structure. Okay, in that linear data structure, we are going to follow the last in first out order. That means we have the important constraint on stack is we are going to perform the insertion and deletion at the one end. Okay, always that end is called as top. Okay, so throughout the session, we are using the three important keywords that are our push, pop and top. Okay, in that previously and all linked list, we are using the keyword insertion, deletion and all. But here in stack, for insertion, we are using the keyword push. For deletion, we are using the keyword pop. Okay, then another operation is top. Okay, that is very, very important. The top, this top is nothing but that this end we are going to perform insertion and deletion. Okay, that is the important constraint of the stack. Okay. Any doubts on this stack? Yeah. The next one, this is a sample representation of stack. Okay. It is last in first out order. If you are going to perform the push operation at the top end, if you want to perform the pop, you have to use this top end. Okay. Next one. Yeah. Here, some of the real-time examples of a stack. Okay. Okay, the first figure, this is a stack of dinner plates, and second one is some puzzles, mathematical puzzle problem, that is towers of henna, and third one is the pack of tennis ball. Okay, then fourth one, day to late, we are going to see that idli plates. Okay, so, all these four examples, these are the example of a stack. Okay, so the first figure, consider the first example. In this example, what is the scenario we are using? How the stack will be applied for this first one? Here, you will always consider this a first example. Here, we are always going to put the place in the stack. Okay, wow. You will always pick up your dinner plate from the top. Okay, top of the stack. And it place, if you want to place again back into the stack, we can always use the top position. Okay, so you will always put it back on the top of the stack. So the plate which is at the top is the first one to be removed. Got it? First one to be removed. That is the plate which has been placed at the top. Okay, well, placed at the top will be removed first. That's why here in stack we are using last in first out order. Okay, or we can call it as first in last out order. Okay, this is the last plate, but when you are going to remove, take the plate from the stack, we are going to remove the first plate. Okay, that is why it is called as last in first out order. Okay, and don't ask if you want to remove the plate in between and all. I already told you, is a possible is there, but in constraints, what I told you in stack, we have one constraint. What is the constraint? You have to insert and delete the element at the top of the stack. Okay, so you have to, based on that constraint, you can consider this example, the first example. Okay, second one, this is the second figure. It shows the, what is it? It is the towers of canal. Already you discussed in that concept, towers of canal. Here we have three rods are there, okay, and multiple disc is multiple discs are there, okay. And what is the concept of this game is we have to move the disc, okay. We have to move this, moving a stack of disc from one peg to another. That is, we have to move the disc from one rod to another, okay. With the concept, with some constraint are there. What is the constraint here? What is the constraint here? Any one of you? What is the constraint for moving disc here? What is the constraint? Any one of you, what is the constraint of cover software moving this? Yes, any one of you? Take one plate at one disk at a time, then one disk should be moved at a time, okay? Suraj, what is the one more constraint? Moving one disk at a time is the one constraint. What is the other? Move top disk, that is also okay. Only small disk on the large disk. Okay, so we hear the constraints are good. The answer is good, Monica. Okay, what is the answer? Only small disk on the large disk. We have the constraint only small disk. Constraint that a disk cannot go on the top of a smaller disk. Okay, these are all the constraint of the tower shop canal. Okay, wow. This is another the example. It shows the concept of stack data structure. This is the tower shop canal concept. What is the next one? Third one is a pack of tennis balls. Here also. Big pack of tennis balls. Okay, here also we are going to insert and remove. We are using this top end. Okay, this top it will use to perform the both insertion operation as well as deletion operation. Okay, that's why this is our first element. This is the last second element. This is the third ball. Okay, when you are going to perform the pop operation, we are going to remove the last element first. Okay, this is another example of stack data structure. Okay. Here also, here lot of plates are there. All they are combinedly put into the middle one. We have in the rod. Okay, so we can't remove the plates in between. Okay, so these are all the real time examples of stack architecture, stack data structure. So these two examples, there is no way you can take out here. Item, okay, and this first one, second one, third, three examples, you can know we can take out a item. That is, we can, if you want to perform insertion and deletion, has to be happen from the top. Okay, so you cannot skip out the item from the bottom or in between. Okay, so that's why we are using the keyword top. So the three keywords, push, pop, and top, is the important keyword in stack data structure. Next one is the applications of stack. We have a lot of applications of stack, but I have listed out only four applications. The first one is the execution of the function calls, which includes also recursive calls also. The second example is the implement undo operation, is one of the applications of stack. And third application is the balancing symbol. This one we are more concentrating on this chapter. Okay. In this balancing the symbol, using this concept, we are going to evaluate the arithmetic expressions. Okay, these four are the applications of stack. The end of this topic, stack applications, we are going to concentrate more on how to evaluate the arithmetic expressions, then how to convert the expression infix to postfix, how to evaluate the postfix expressions, and all we are going to discuss in the end of this stack chapter. Okay, so now. Execution of the function call. First one, first application is the execution of function calls. Okay, what is it? It is used for execution of function calls in your program, as well as we can apply the recursive calls also. Okay, this stack application is used for recursive function. That is that nothing but the chain of function calls. We can call the same function itself again and again. That is the concept of recursive calls. Okay, the second one, implement undo operation application, is this used to implement this undo operations in an editor. Okay, so we can perform undo operation in any text editor or image editor. Okay, you have to find out how the stack will be performed. Okay, so for when you are pressing the control Z, okay, as we can see, the some of the text that I have written is getting clear. Okay, so you can implement this using the stack data structure. Okay, that undo operation, it will remove, clear the last recently what we have edited in the editor tab. Okay, so the undo operation is the last first out data structure. Okay, this is an important application of stack. The second, third one is the balancing symbol, which is nothing but balancing symbol is another application of stack. Okay. Here the compiler verifies whether the parentheses in your source code are okay, balanced or not. Okay, that is the concept of balancing the symbol. Okay. This will perform in the compiler part. Every time when you are compiling the entire source code, every time the compiler it will check, okay, whether the opening calibrator or opening parenthesis in your source code, there must be closing parenthesis or appropriate position. Okay, the compiler it will check all the opening and closing parenthesis are appropriately placed in there. Okay, now and if parenthesis in your source code are not properly, what will happen? So immediately the compiler shows some error. Okay, that's why this kind of check can be performed using the stack data structure. Okay, so all are keep it in your mind. The balancing symbol is nothing but we are going to check whether all the opening calibration or parenthesis or whatever it may be must be placed properly. The closing parenthesis are there properly. This will check using this concept stack data structure. Next one is the evaluating arithmetic expressions. As I told you, we discuss in this end of this chapter, we will discuss clearly. It includes all the arithmetic conversion infix to postfix as well as evaluations of the postfix expression. We will discuss in this under this topic. Okay, these are all the applications of stack. Next one, shall I proceed? These are only some sample example and applications of stack. Applications we will discuss the end of this stack chapter. Okay. Now, implementation of stack. Okay, the stack implementation in link we have seen in linked list also we are implemented in two ways, arrays as well as linked list pointer concept. Okay, the same thing here. Stack can be implemented in two way. One is the implementation using array. Another second method is the implementation using linked list. That is, this is a pointer concept. Linked list is nothing but pointer concept. This is for only array concept. Okay. These are all the two methods for implementing stack. First one already we know that what is an array. Array is a collection of similar data type. Okay. It has a fixed size. Data must be in fixed size. If only problem with this implementation of array is size must be specified initially. At the runtime, we cannot. What is it? At the runtime, we cannot resize the array size. Okay, that's why we go for linked list concept. Another word, this array is a static memory allocation. This linked list is a dynamic memory allocation. Okay, now we are going to discuss of the array implementation first, then we will discuss about the linked list implementation. Okay, in array, again we are going to create a structure stack. Structure name is stack, which includes the members maximum size and one more variable top. Okay, this is the notation of the array implementation. Okay, whether you can list out this is for elements if you are inserting and display. Okay, now we will discuss next slide. This is the second type, linked list representation. Whenever you are going to implement the particular data structure in the linked list point of view, we are going to create a node. Okay, already I told you node depends on the corresponding type. The node will be differ. Okay, here is a simply, this is similar to singly linked list, so the node which has the two parts, the first part it refers to the data part and second one it always refers to the address of the next node. Okay, so this is a node structure of this stack data structure. This is a structure of the node. Okay, then I have, if whenever you are having the pointer, temporary pointer variable, you have to declare it. Okay, this is a representation of linked list. Now, first we are going to discuss about the array implementation, then we go for linked list implementation. Okay, so now these are all the basic operations on stack. What are the basic operations are available? Already we discussed more. I told you push is, which is nothing but is a insertion. Pop is a similar operation of deletion, and peek. Okay, note it down, or you just note it down, or you take a screenshot. These are all the important operations we are going to perform on the stack data structure. Now, third one is a peek. What is peak? Peak is nothing but it returns, always it returns top of the element. Okay, peak, or if you want, you can use the keyword top. Both are same only. Okay, top or peak, it always returns the top of the element in the stack. Okay, is empty. What is the use of is empty? Whether our stack is, this function it returns whether our stack is empty or not. Okay, is full, again this function it returns whether our stack is full or not. Okay, the last is the default operation or the display function. Okay, these are all the basic operations we are going to perform on the stack. Next, we will discuss one by one. So all are only array implementation. Okay, now here implementation using arrays. Okay, what is the first one? Push operation, that is insert operation. Okay, so assume here so to perform this insertion, first one here I am using the stack size. Okay, you can declare in and the size of the max. Okay, max sizes, assume max sizes, max sizes equal to 5. Okay, assume 5 in this example. Now if you are going to perform push operation, already I told you, first you have to check whether our stack is full or not. Okay, that is you are going to check the overflow condition. Okay, that is the very first step for inserting element into the stack. Okay, if our stack is overflow, we can't insert the new element inside the stack. Okay, that's why first you are going to check whether our stack is full or not. Okay, how can we check the check whether our stack is full or not? Consider this example here. In stack we have 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, 4 elements are there. Already I told you that top, the keyword top, it always points to the top of the element in the stack. Okay, so how can we check whether our stack is full or not? Okay, yes. In this example our stack, the maximum size is 5. Okay, maximum size is 5. So now what is the top value? Here top is equal to, yes, 1, 2, 3, 4. Here top is equal to 4. Then you have to check top double equal to 5. Okay, what the function it return? If the condition is true, it return 1, otherwise it returns 0. Here top is not equal to maximum size. Still one more element is there. Still we are going to insert one more element. Okay, so now here, after inserting 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Take this example. In this stack, we have 5 elements are there. So now, what is the value in top? Top is equal to 5. Okay. In this situation, you have to check, call the is full function. Call the full function, check whether top double equal to maximum size minus 1. Okay. What is the maximum size? Okay. What is the maximum size? Actually, you have to check whether our top is double equal to maximum size minus 1. Why I am taking this minus 1? Usually, the array declaration, the index is starting from 0th position. Okay. Yes, index is starting from 0th position. I will tell you later in this part that will be applicable. Okay, that's why I am taking maximum minus 1. Okay, actual size is 5. So I am taking max minus 1, checking here. Okay. So now, take one example. So now I am going to insert the elements one by one. Consider this example, taking the elements are 3, 5, then you have to take 9, 1, 12. Okay, consider these are elements which we are going to insert into the stack. Okay. Now, the very first time, okay, assume our top value is here only, because what is the status? This is initially our stack is empty. Okay, that's why my top is equal to minus one. Okay, I'm going to declare the variable top. I'm initializing this top is equal to minus one. That's why my stack is empty. Got it? Initially, my stack is empty. Yes. Now that is the top is equal to minus one. That is no more element inside the stack. Now I'm going to insert the first element. So what is the procedure? This is the routine for push operation. I am passing the data 3 here. Okay, passing the data 3 here. So it enter into the function, push function. First step, I told you, whenever you are inserting the new element, immediately you have to check whether our stack is full or not. See, in this example, now our stack is empty. Okay, if you want, you can go and check. Call the isFull function. So the control is transferred here. Inside this full function, we got the first statement top double equal to max minus one. Okay, what is the top value? Top value, I told you, top is initialized by minus one. Okay, which is not equal to max minus one is 4. Okay, yes, yeah, this is not equal to, that's why it will enter into this. And what is this isFull function? It returns true or false. Okay, got it? Here the isFull, it returns either 0 or 1. That is similar to Boolean representation, true or false. Okay, if it is true, okay, or the not, here I'm using the not operator, so it will enter into this function body. What is the very first step for insertion? First, you have to increment top by 1. Now, I am incrementing this top by 1. Now, what is the top value? Top is equal to minus 1 plus 1. Top is equal to 0. Okay, top is equal to 0. Okay, first increment the top value. Then you have to assign the data in the corresponding position. What is stack of top? Stack is nothing but our array name. Here I am passing top value. What is our top value? 0. So that means stack of 0, first index. This is array representation, so that it starts from 0th index. Okay. So stack of 0, I am going to place the element data. Which element I am passing this push function? 3. Got it? Yes, this is the first instruction. Next, I am going to insert the second element, 5. Okay, 5. Whether you have to check your stack is full or not. Actually, I already told you, I'm initializing maximum size is 5. Okay, now you have to check top is equal to maxi size minus 1. What is the new top value? 0. Okay, so 0, which is not equal to our maximum size minus 1, 4. Okay, what is it not equal to? Okay, the condition is true or false. False. Okay. Else part, it returns 0. That's why you enter into the else part. What is that? Top is equal to top plus 1. Increment this top by 1. Now top is equal to 1. Top is equal to top plus 1. Previously top value is 0. So 0 plus 1, 1. So top is equal to 1. Then place this first index. What is the value? 5. Okay. The value 5 is there. What is the next one? Again, insert the third element. What is the third element? 9. Again, you have to check. What is the top value? 1. 1 is not equal to 4. Okay. Then increment top by 1. Top is equal to now. Here 9, increment top. This top is equal to 2 here. Okay. Then so in the index 2, we are passing 9. Again increment next insert. Call the push function again. Okay. Now check whether top, now our top is equal to 2, which is not equal to 4. Okay, not equal to 4. Then increment top by 1. Now top is equal to 3. Then place the third is the new element 1. again call the function. Okay, what is the function here? Top is equal to 3, which is not equal to, again, which is not equal to 4. Then increment top by 1. Increment top by 1, that is top is equal to 4. What is the element? 12. In fourth index, we are going to pass the element 12. Next time, again, once again, I am calling the push function. It will check the recent top value is 4. 4 is equal to our maximum size minus 1. Okay. Now the condition is true. It returns 1. Okay. That's what is the next one? It won't enter into this block. Okay. It come out from here. So after this insertion, I inserted the maximum size. What is my maximum size? Array size is 5. So up to this maximum size, 5 elements are possible. Okay, to insert the 5. If you want to insert 3 elements, no problem. Okay. But more than 5, we can't insert because our checking condition is whether if once the stack is full, we can't insert the further elements into the stack. Okay. This is the procedure. How to insert the element into the stack. Okay, so keep it in your mind. Whenever you are going to perform the insertion push operation, you must check the what is the condition? Overflow condition. Okay, that is overflow is nothing but whether our stack is full or not. Got it? This is a simple implementation of stack. Any doubts on this? This is a sort of algorithm I have written here. This is the procedure, basic concepts about the push operation. Shall I proceed? Pop, any doubt? Any doubts on the push? Shall I proceed for the next operation? Others response me? Any doubt on this? If you have any doubt, you put it in the chat box for push operation. Students respond me? Any doubts? Yes, any doubts on push operation?
Jai Shiva, Monica, no. Okay, ma. Okay.
The next operation, pop operation. Okay. Pop is nothing but we are going to perform the deletion operation. Okay. We are going to remove the element from the stack. Already I told you, whenever if you are going to perform the insertion or deletion, we must concentrate on the top or the element, because this is a structure. What is the structure here we are using? Stack. Stack in turn, it follows the last in first out order or first in last out order. These two you have to always keep in your mind for data stack data sets. Okay, now pop operation, which is similar to the daily insertion push. We are checking first step whether our stack is, what is the overflow. Whenever we are going to perform the pop operation, the very first step is we are going to check whether our stack is underflow or not. Okay, whether our stack is underflow, that means underflow is nothing but our stack is empty or not. If our stack is empty, we cannot perform the pop operation. We need some elements on there. Okay, if element is there, we are going to perform pop. Okay, if our stack is empty, we can't perform the pop operation, is not at all possible. So that first step you have to check is empty. Okay, well, that's why I am calling the function is empty here. This is a routine of the pop operation. Okay, pop. Here I am declaring one temporary variable data. Already I told you, call the empty function. Okay, so keep it in your mind. This will returns the boolean value. Okay, a boolean true or false, or you can write the integer 0 and 1. Okay, now here you have already told you this example. Initially, what is the status of this? Okay, if our stack is empty, this is the empty stack. This is our stack. Okay, if our stack is empty, what about the top value? Top is always, yes, top is all. What is the top? Top is always minus 1. Okay, this is a condition to check whether our stack is empty or not. Okay, so directly you can check if top double equal to minus 1, our stack is empty. Okay, otherwise we can proceed for pop operation. Okay, Okay, any doubts on this? How we have to check the our stack is empty or not using this top value -1. -1 it represents our stack is empty. Now call the function pop. First check whether it is not empty. Okay, true. If it is not empty, enter into this pop condition. What is it? Stack of top. Okay, imagine. Now take this example. In this example, I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, 5 elements are there. So that my top is equal to what is the top value? Here it is increment. This -1 to increment by 1. Here top is equal to 0. Here top is equal to 1. This is top is equal to 2, 3. Now here top is equal to 4. Okay. So what the first step? Stack of top. Okay, that is 4th index. Okay. So stack of top 4. Okay, you can assign that value to data. Okay. What is the value here? E. Now the data has the element E. Okay. Now what is the next step? You can reduce top is equal to top -1. Now I am changing this top position here -1. One position we are going to decrement. So now the top is pointed to the 4th element. That is the index is 3. Okay. Then what is the once you reduce the top by 1, return data. What is the data in this? What is the data in this? E. Okay, ma'am. That will be written. That means it is a popped out from the stack. Rita, else if the condition is true, it perform pop operation. Otherwise, it will return your stack is empty. This else part, we have the statement stack is empty. Rita, again, next you perform the first step, assign this stack of 4, third place, okay? Stack of 3rd, top, to the data. Okay, now our data is D. Okay, now our data is D. Then change the top position here. Now this is top value. Okay, once you change the top pointer, then only you have to return the data. So it will return E. That is the pop operation. This is for how to remove the element from the stack. Okay. So this is so the entire scenario it shows. This is the last element. Last element is the E. Okay, but when you are going to remove the removing the process, we are going to remove the last element is the first. Okay, that is last in first order. Then last in first out. Or you have to write first in last out procedure. Any doubts on this? This is a pop operation. Only two conditions. First, you check whether our stack is underflow, that is empty or not. If it is not empty, you can proceed. Remove the element from the top one by one. Okay. From the top one by one. So in push operation, you consider we are incrementing top, then we can insert the element. Okay. In pop, once you assign that value, pop value to that data, then you can decrease the top position by 1. Assignment is first, then you are going to decrement. In push operation, we can increment the top, then we are assigning the value. Only two things you have to concentrate on. Okay, any doubts on this pop operation? Any doubts on this pop operation? Yeah, any doubts? Shall I proceed for the next one? Now next one, Mithi is doing, no, okay. Next is peak. Already I told you, peak is nothing but it always returns the top of the element. Whenever if you want to print what is the top element in the stack, you can just call the function peak or top. That is user defined function, so whatever name you want, you can use, okay. So in a technical word, here they are using peak or top, okay. So what is the code inside this? Return stack of top. Okay, this is nothing but consider this example. Top is equal to 4. So I am using stack of top. That is nothing but stack of 4, the 4th index. Okay, what is the element in that 4th index? It return. Okay, that is return type is what is it? The function it should return integer value. That's why the 4 will be returned. So what is the data on 4th index? E. so it always returns the top of the element. So the keyword top is very very important. Okay, so if just you pass the top, it shows whether which element is the topmost element. Okay, that is a peak function. Next one is a void display. Yes, void display, as usual display, it will display what are all the elements inside the stack one by one. This is here I am using that temporary variable I for iteration purpose. Okay, initially if you have to take I is equal to top, consider this example, what is the top value here? 4. So now I am going to take i is equal to 4. Okay, that is the initialization. Then what is our condition, whether this I is greater than or equal to 0? Yes, my 4 is greater than or equal to 0, it is true. It enter into this true block. What is that for inside that? We have the print stack of I. What is this stack of I? Here we are passing the I is 4. Okay, I is 4. So it display the element. What is the element in that fourth position? E. Okay, that is our concept, no? Last in, first out, E. Okay, then enter into this increment or decrement part. Here I am using I minus minus. So what is I minus minus? That is 4 minus minus 3. Now again you check I is equal to 3. Okay, 3 is greater than or equal to 0. Okay, what is the condition? S of 3. Then pop display S of 3. What is the value? E. Okay, then decrement I by 1, 2. Check again, 2 is greater than or equal to 0. Then it refers the S of 0 index. In that index we have C. It will display C. One is greater than or equal to 0. Okay, then decrement S. Yes. S of 1 we have B. Then again decrement I by 1, 0, which is two conditions here, we have greater than or equal to. So 0 is equal to 0. It can display the 0th index. What is the value here? In 0th index, we have A. In 0th index, we have the data A. Again, next you have to decrement minus 1. So minus 1 is not greater than or equal to 0. Here the condition is false, so it will come out from the. Okay, so this is a display function. It's a normal for loop iteration using the variable I. Here the important keyword is you have to initialize I to the top. Okay, I always having the top value, then only we have to retrieve the last element first. Any doubts on this insertion operations? Yeah, for array, the basic operations on stack is push, pop, peek, is empty, is full, and display. Okay, so these are all the basic operations on the array implementation. Any doubts on this? Any doubts on this? Shall I proceed to the next topic? Yes. Yes. Okay. Now. Is the demo part of stack implementation easy? All right. Using the platform, 4-step platform to run the code. Can you all see my screen, ports of screen? Ipana ma'am, theriyuda ports of?
Yes ma'am, yes ma'am.
Ah, okay, thank you. So in that code sir, first you have to select which language you are going to use. Wait, I will increment the font size. Is it visible? Just to take the screenshot. First, I am initializing the maximum sizes by whatever we discussed in that PPT. I am converting into that code using C language. Yeah, initialize the maximum sizes file. As I told you, initialize top is equal to minus 1. Okay. Take the screenshot. This is the first function, is empty. One by one, you can take it. Is empty. Now this is a function for is full. Whether check your stack is full or not. This is a routine for full, and this is a routine for peak top. Take the screenshot, ma. Make it fast. Okay. Then next one. This is a pop operation. This is a pop. Here the stack is empty. Keyword is stack is empty here. Okay. Yeah, pop operation. Next one, push operation. This is the code for push. Okay, check whether stack is full or not, then do the procedure for push. Next one is for display. This is a routine for display. Yeah, next one is the main program. Okay, next is the main program. Call the push function one by one. Here I am using passing arguments. Okay, that's why I am calling the function with the arguments. Or if you want, already I told you, if you use the scanf statement inside your program, you just use the option custom input. From that custom input, you can give the inputs, then you can start the run button. Okay. Here I am using the function call is function without return value and with arguments. Okay, that's why I am using this kind of syntax here. Okay. Now, next one. Next part of the main. Push, pop and display. Got it, Amma? So now, first, I'm going to run this program. Say, check my stack size. I initialized as 5. Okay, that means it accepts only 5 elements. But inside this main, I'm passing first, I'm calling the push function 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I'm calling this push function 6 times. Okay, wow. That's why I am passing 6 elements. So, what will happen? Whether it shows the error. Or it shows whatever statement inside that else part. What is the output of this program? Here I am passing 6 elements. Okay. Any one of you give the answer in the chat box? Any one of you, here I am passing 6 elements. I am going to insert 6 elements into the stack. What will happen here? What is our first statement, output statement? Yeah. What is it? Overflow. Good. That's why I told you every time if you are performing the insertion operation, you must check whether our stack is full or not. That is check the overflow condition. So see, what is the output of this program? Run the program. Sakina, good overflow condition. See, this is our output statement. What is the first output? Could not insert the data. That means our stack is full. Okay. So what is our status? So after this, when you are going to insert the last 15th element, it shows the error like this. Okay, that is overflow condition. Your stack is full. Further, you can't insert the data. Then after that, I am calling the function display. Okay, that's why is display. What are all the elements inside that stack? What are the elements display? The last 12, 1, 9, 5, 3. Okay, so display, it display what are the elements inside the stack. Then I'm calling the pop function 1, 2, 3, 4 times. Okay, when I'm calling pop the first time, it pop the first top of the element from the stack. Okay, here I'm calling peek function. Printf enter at the top of the stack. Here I'm calling peek. Okay, after the display, I'm calling the peek function. That's why I got the statement here, element at the top of the stack is equal to 12. Okay, after this 12, I am calling the pop function 4 times. So it pop the element one by one, the top element, next to topmost element, then 9 and 5. Okay, so what is the next one? After this pop, it display all those element, call the display function. So the remaining in stack, I have only one element, 3 only left up. That's why item in stack or 3. Now what is the statement here? Here I have the two printf statements. So in this statement, which operator I am using? Here, what is the type of operator here I am using? Any one of you? What is the type of operator here I am using? Yeah, ternary operator or conditional operator. Good. Nityashree and Harish. Always using the same name. What about others are doing? Yeah, conditional operator. Good. Hello, Gautam Reddy. Yeah, this is a ternary operator or conditional operator. If the condition is true, it will execute the first part. Otherwise, it will execute the second part. Okay, that is the operation of this ternary operator. Here is full. So at this state, after the push and pop, in our stack, it has only one element, that is 3. Okay, so you can call the isFull function whether our stack is full or not. Is it true or false? Yeah, false. That's why it return else part statement, false. Okay, next, call the isEmpty function whether our stack is empty or not. No, this is false. Again, it will return the false statement. This is our output. Stack is full, false. Stack is empty, false. Still we have one more element is there in stack. Okay, any doubt? This is the procedure of implementing stack using array. Any doubts on this code? Yes, any doubts on this code? If you want, you can do one more thing. You can remove all those elements. Then first time you can call the pop. Okay, check the condition whether our stack is empty or not. Okay, then you can run the program. Okay, lot of possibilities are there. You just change the function call. Okay, then you will find out the difference whether you will get all the function call properly. Is empty, is full, and all, is it working properly or not? You can check it yourself. Got it? Yes, code is also there. You must do the practice in CodeChef platform. Okay, now next we are going to discuss about the linked list representation of stack. Next one, yeah, implementation of stack using linked list. Linked list is nothing but we are going to use the pointer concept. Okay, that means we are using dynamic memory allocation. As I already told you, this is similar to singly linked list, so that we need the node representation like this. The node, it has two part. First one is always is a data field. If you want, you can use integer data as well as floating point data, whatever it may be. First part is the data part, and second part is the address part. That means it points the address of the next node. It holds the address of the another node. Okay. Yes, this is the structure of the node structure. I hope you are very very familiar with this node declaration and all. Struct, keyword struct, node name. Inside we have two parts: only data part and the address part. What is the data type of this pointer variable next? What is the data type of this pointer variable next? Is the node type, structure node type. That's why I am passing struct node. Okay, this pointer, it points to the another node. Okay, that's why I am passing struct node type here. Okay. Yeah, this is a logical representation of the stack. Okay, logical representation of our stack. Assume this is our stack. Yeah, this is our stack. Okay. First, initially we are going to insert the node. Okay, initial stack we have three elements. Okay, if initially first element is 11. Okay, insert the 11 or first element 11. At that time, the top it points to the first node. Okay, it points to the first node. Then next time, increment top by 1. Then insert the second element. At that time, the top will points to the second node in the stack. Okay, then third element. After the third element, increment top by 1. So now the top points to the third element. Now finally, the what is our last top value? Top, it holds the address of the third node. Okay, address of the third. Always, I told you, we are going to declare the pointer variable. Top is a pointer variable. It holds the address of the another node. Okay, so the top, it points to the third node. That means it holds the address of the third node, not the integer data. 33 is not there because it is a pointer variable. Okay, ma'am. So the corresponding node address it holds, that is 4800. This is another representation. Now, the same operations also we are going to perform here in a linked list implementation. Push, pop, peek, is empty, is full, and display. We will discuss one by one. This is a linked list representation of push operation. What I told you, what is the basic concept in that insert push operation? First, we have to check our overflow condition. Okay. Check the overflow condition. That means whenever we are going to check overflow, you can call that function. Okay, ma. This is a linked list representation. So what we have to do in linked list representation, this is the same procedure. What is it? Struct node, already we declare here node structure. Okay, same thing here I'm doing. Declaration part is over. After this declaration, okay, after this declaration here, I am declaring one temporary pointer variable, that is top. Okay, top is the pointer I am declaring. Already I told you how to declare the pointer variable using the corresponding data type. Okay, this pointer variable points to the address of the another node. That's why I'm using struct node. Okay, so declaration part is over. Then start waiting for the push operation. Okay, this is for push. Next one. First thing, inserting the new node. Assume this is our new node N. Okay, this is dynamic memory allocation. Okay. What is the concept we are using for dynamic memory allocation? This is a new node, struct node ASCII N. We are going to allocate memory dynamically so that we are using the function malloc. Through this malloc, we are going to allocate the memory. Okay, here the size of operator, it returns the void pointer. We can convert this into struct node type pointer so that here we are doing typecasting. So finally, the node, it has some address. What is the address here? 5000. Assume after this malloc, the operations or the performing this malloc operation, is it clearly, that is it perform perform clearly means it allocates memory properly n it has some memory address. Assume now n it has a 5000. Okay, some random address it will refer from the heap data set. Okay, I already told you this is for dynamic memory allocation. We always refer the heap data set, heap memory allocation. Okay, so after this we have to check immediately whether the allocation is properly or not. Okay, so if not equal to n, what is the concept is here not equal to n. Here not is the negotiation operator. Okay, if not equal to n means if it does not, that is this is true if n is equal to 0. Okay, note it down. Okay, the meaning of if not n meaning is this is negotiation operator. Okay, here what condition I am using here, this is true, the condition is true if n is equal to 0 or null. Okay, that is which is similar to if you want you can use n double equal to null, whatever it may be you can use. Here one of the representation exclamatory n is negotiation operator, it will check n is it true, it is n is equal to 0 or null. I told you assume now n it has 5000, so it is if it is true it check is the heap is overflow, it return exit minus. See once again one more thing, what is the use of here exit 1, exit 0, exit, or what is the any idea about exit 1 and exit 0? Yes, give the answer in chat box. What is the exit of 0, what is the meaning of exit of 1? Yes. Yes. Response, Bhima. What is the difference between exit of 0 and exit of 1? Yeah. Exit of 0 is always returns that indication of successful termination. Okay. We have to terminate the given promo successfully. Okay. Exit of 0. Exit of 1 is unsuccessful termination. Marita. Yes. All you should note it down. Exit of 0. Harish, good. Others also you can respond, Nima. Whatever you know, if your answer is wrong, no problem. You are going to learn something, no? Yeah, exit of 0 is nothing but successful termination. That is, the program has been executed without any error or interrupt. Note it down. Exit of 0 is nothing but successful execution. That is, the program has been executed without any error or interrupt. Okay, here. Exit of 1 is nothing but, yes, exit of 1 is nothing but abnormal termination or failure execution, that is abnormal termination of the program. That is, the program will be terminated with some error or interrupt. Okay, that is the indication of this exit of 1. Okay. Yeah, if it is, yes, proceed. Exit of 1 and exit of 0. Yeah, here this is true if n is equal to 0. Okay, if n is equal to 0, you can enter into this part. Otherwise, here n it has some memory address 5000. Assume n it has memory is properly allotted to the new pointer variable n. So now it holds the address of 5000. Okay. Now what is our first step? Checking general over. Yes. In the stack we are using. Now we are calling that memory function overflow is full function directly and all. Okay. But here dynamic memory allocation it always inter communication with heap data, so heap memory allocation. Okay. That's why it always shows the memory. Memory allocation, it gives the status about the heap. Okay, so that heap overflow. We are using heap overflow. Yeah, now after this, enter into this else part. In this else part, you can do first one, n of data. This is a node reference n. We can access data part through n arrow data. If you want to access this next field, n arrow next. That and all we know very well. So n of data is equal to num. What is the meaning of n of data is equal to num? Yeah. What is this? Enough data is equal to num. Here we are assigning. What is the address here? What is the address here? Yes. We can assign n of num is equal to n of data field. Here I am passing some integer value. Assume my integer data path is 11. Okay. Here now I am passing 11 here. Assume this 11 to the data, n of data. So now this n of data path shows the integer value 11. So data path is over. What is our next part? What is our next part? Yes. Next is equal to top. Okay, wow. Now n of next is equal to top. What is the top? Any idea about top? Yes, any idea about top? Here n of next is equal to top. That means now n of next field is pointing to the top address. Okay, I told you once the node is inserted. Okay, what is the value of that top? Any idea about this? Yes, what is the meaning of this? N of next is equal to top. Any one of you? Oh, yes, structure declaration, that is node declaration again you want. Huh? What is it, node declaration here? So this is my node structure. It has two parts, data part and next field part. That's why I'm declaring node, struct node int data. Struct node of pointer variable. Harish, marandutya? Is a pointer variable, as it is a normal pointer variable, if we are using int asterisk next, asterisk p, whatever it may be. But here, this pointer variable, it holds the address of the another node. That's why I am passing the data type is struct node type. Okay. After this, structure declaration is over. After this, structure declaration is over. Okay, so outside the structure, I'm going to create one temporary pointer variable, top. Okay, struct node, top. This is a temporary pointer variable. Okay, top. Then we can go for the insertion function. After this, any doubts now, Harish? Which one, struct node? Fulla marandutya. Okay, what is the struct node? See, after this, this is a declaration part, okay. This is a declaration part of node, new node. Okay, this is a temporary pointer variable top. We are going to use for some other purpose. Now, assume we are going to insert the new node n. Okay, how we can allocate, this is a pointer concept. So this is a declaration as well as we are going to initializing then allocating memory. Okay, so for that this is a standard statement. Struct node, new node variable is equal to. Okay, call the how to allocate the memory allocation in dynamically. Call the malloc function. So malloc, what is the syntax of malloc function? Malloc of size of, what is the size of the argument we are passing. Okay, so malloc is a function name. Inside that argument we are passing size of struct node. Okay, if you know the pointer normal variable size of int a means it allocate based on that data type int, it will tell the what is the size of int. But here this is a node, so we don't know the what is the size of this data type, what are all the members inside this node. Okay, that's why we are passing entire node structure. So this size of operator, it returns what is the data type of this, what is the return type, what is the size of this entire node structure, which is in the void pointer. Always malloc function, it returns generic data type, okay, or void pointer type. It is some unpositive number it returns, but we don't want normal unpositive number because our new node is a pointer node, which is the type of struct node. We need memory allocation, some memory address, so that here we are doing convert this void data pointer into struct node pointer type casting. Garita, this malloc, it returns some positive unsigned positive integer that will be converted into struct node pointer type. But it does, so finally the pointer, the node star n, it holds the address of some memory address. So I am telling in this example you have to assume some memory is allotted. That is, you can take the example 5000 for n equals the address of 5000. Got it? If the process is over properly is allocated, the n does not having null value, it enter into this else part. Okay. Otherwise, if n is equal to null, it shows the heap overflow. No more memory is allotted. Okay, some error is there. That's why I'm using exit one, unsuccessful termination. Okay, unsuccessful termination. Got it? Any doubts on this, Harish? Yeah, any doubts? Okay, now shall I proceed? Yeah. So first thing, enter into this else part. Else part. First, we are going to assign. Now the node structure is over. Two parts. Already we know how to access the data part, how to access the next part. Okay. Now this data path is assume num n 11 is assigned to data part of the new node n. So n of data is equals the num 11. Okay. Assume first I am passing 11. Okay. Then what is the next step? Top is equal to n of next. What is the top is equal to n of next? Yes, first time. What is the top is equal to? We can assign what is the address in top. Okay, wow. First time I told you what is the address in this top. The very first node you can assume the address of this next field is null. Okay, very first time. Okay, after that you can assign this n is equal to top. Assign this n address is equal to. Now this I will explain the next node after the next node insertion. Okay, so for very first time the next field is null. Okay, now what is the address here? N is equal to top. Assign the new node address 5000. Now the top it holds the 5000. Okay, now insert the second one, second element. Now I am going to insert the 22. So what will happen? Assign 22 in data path. Okay. Assume this is our recent element 22. What is the next one? Assign top is equal to n arrow next, because this is the next topmost recent topmost element. That's why this element it points to the previous one. Okay. How can we access this 5000? That's why 5000 is top is equal to n of next. Okay. What is the n of next? Previously, initially top is equal to 5000. Now, what is the value in top? 5000. This top will be assigned to n of next. Now, this is our new node. Okay, this is our new node. Got it? When you are calling the second time push operation, okay, again you enter into this push function with new data 22. Okay, 22. Again, new node n is creation. So this is our new node. This is the data part of the new. This is the next part of the new. So now, what is the n of next of this top? What is the value top? That's why this arrow. The meaning of this arrow is top assigning the address of top to the n of next. So it points this arrow link. Okay, the meaning of this arrow. Next one. Now you have to change the top. Now this is now at this time 22 is our topmost element. So we are going to change the top address. Okay. Now what is our top? Top will point to the recent node, topmost node. What is our 22? Now assign this node address to top. What is the node address? 4900. Okay. 4900 is in top. Okay. Over on. Again, once again I call the push function with the data value of 33. Okay, the data part is 33. So what is the data part value? 33. I am calling the push function once again. Assume data part is 33. Then assume what is the top value? 4900. Okay, what is the 33 top? Is equal to assign whatever address in the top to the n of next. In a top we have 4900. So this next part is connected with 4900 node. Okay, that's why in this part we are having 900. Then you change that link, okay, as a new node. Now this is our new node. Now this is our new node. So assign this address. What is the address here? 4800. Correct? 4800. Got it? Any doubts? Like that, you have to insert the next element. Okay. What is the next element? Last one. Insert the 44. Then next field is pointed to the previous node. Then top is equal to 4700. Here you got to change. This is 4700. Now the last top value is for 4700. This is the procedure for insert the node into the stack push operation. Okay, only two things: first update the data part, update the next part. Okay, initially the name, the next field is a null. Okay, so what we have to do? Initially it is null means if no more data is a null, otherwise it will take the top value 4500. Got it? But very first time, if you are asking, very first time that I told you some memory address is there, that you consider here 5000. Okay. Now it will increment one by one, pointed to the previous node, pointed to the previous node. Like that, you have to